Was this kind of like a family thing? You were at a family reunion, said, hey, let's form a band?
No,
or
we
what
went
happened?
Down the family tree.
Picked out the best players of each instrument.
No, actually, it's just like a thing. It was never, when we were younger, went, let's get all cousins to form a band. It was more or less just, we hung around each other when we were young. And it's just the basic thing that any group of friends does. Let's form a band. Okay, you be this, and you be this. And it seems like some people did that, and we actually took instruments, took lessons at it, and boom.
So you all just divided the instruments up and said, you know, you'll do that, play that instrument. And,
Well, we had an idea of what each person wanted to do. Mm-hmm. Like, when we were growing up, we were just hanging out, listening to music and, like, Black Sabbath and AC/DC and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And then we just started playing copies, and it just started to evolve, started to click.
Now, you're still all under 21, right?
Two of us are now 21.
Okay, cause does that present a problem, you know, for gigs in certain bars or whatever?
No, the problem with age has never really affected where we've played. Mm-hmm. I mean, we've played overage shows for 21 and over. It's just the one thing that's kind of affected. It's not really any big thing. It's just kind of affected us a bit when a lot of people in press push so much on the age thing and they almost overlook the musical aspect, and that kind of gets to be down. When you hear this isn't much of a compliment when you hear, they're great for their age.
Oh,
thank you.
You find a lot of people doing that?
Not so much anymore. It was more or less the first album where they really pressed that a lot.
When everyone was under 18 and stuff, but now it's like everyone's getting older and I'm the only one in school now, so I'm just trying to deal with it.
Yeah, how are your grades, by the way?
I don't know, I haven't gotten my report card yet.
So speaking of albums, you have a new album out, which is Frolic Through the Park.
There you go.
Now, your first album was inspired, the title of the album was inspired by Clockwork Orange. How about Frolic Through the Park?
It's an older song of ours, and it's, we just kind of...
For instance, or bass line, or guitar riff.
Well, Rob, he's not here right now, but he's the
Where is
song.
Rob, by the way?
Where is that Rob, you know? He's lagging, no.
He's the main songwriter, and he just has, like, a riff, and he presents it to us, and we just start jamming, and just, like, it starts to flow from there. Mostly the songs that we've made on the new album, Frog Through the Park, have just been, like, just messing around.
Yeah,
and
they a lot just of spontaneity sort of just, behind it.
Yeah, just sort of just click together.
Not bad for just messing around.
Oh, yeah, it's great.
Feelings behind it, though.
Exactly. It comes from here and not from the head.
All right, you guys are going to hang out for a little bit longer.
Dream of leaving.
We'll talk some more. Right now, Megadeth here with Wake Up Dead right here on the Headbangers Ball. On the Headbangers Ball, with me, as you can see right now, Andy and Mark from Death Angel. These other guys are never going to make it, are they? We're just going to...
No.
You have to tell them what they missed out on,
yeah.
I guess.
Let's see. We're having the best time of your lives. Best time is a mere understatement for how much fun me and Andy are having right now. How about you, Adam?
I'm having a grand old time. Now, what is next for you guys? I mean, you got this album out. You're going to promote this, obviously.
Yeah.
Road-wise?
Well, we started off in Europe first, and then we came through U.S., which we're doing about now, and we have about a little less than a month left, and then we go home for about 2 weeks, and then we tour the West Coast. And this is the headlining part. And then we get back and then hopefully just link on a major support tour.
Hopefully.
As we already, you know, we don't really want to talk about age here, but...
There we go.
What do you expect still to come for Death Angel? Because, you know, you have so much ahead of you.
Yeah, I feel like... it's unpredictable, yeah.
Just to go on and just make more music.
Mm-hmm.
But always run forward.
And never look back?
Exactly. I always look back and go, what's up?
Hey, guys, I want to thank you very much for dropping by. And you're always welcome. You know that. And Headbanger's Ball is going to continue now for you with, Def Leppard?
Def Leppard.
I mean, the question is, do you guys look in the mirror when you make love?
Often when I make love, I look in the mirror. Oh, wait.
Maybe not. Here's Love Bites.